Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In this tutorial, we are going to create a sticky menu. Stay tuned. Now, in the first case, all we are going to do, we are going to check on what we are about to create in this tutorial. Now, we can see that this is an HTML page and here comes a menu which is already been created over here, a horizontal one. And if we scroll down the page, we can see that the menu item is now sticking to the topmost position while the rest of the contents are stacked below it. So this is what we are going to create into our current project on which we are working on. And we can see that we have created already an element with a sticky position here, which is sticking into the topmost position. Now we will implement the same thing into our horizontal menu that we have created in our previous case. So let's get back to our project, and this is the menu holder. So all we are going to do in the first case, we need to discard off this position sticky here. So we are going to discard them. In the first case, we are going to mute them off. And now in the menu holder, all we are going to do, we are going to create from where? From top zero position. Now before we move on further, first of all, I'd like to say you that this is a very basic and simple procedure or tutorial that we have created with the aid of HTML and CSS only. But in case of finer tunes, for say we want some more specifications associated to this particular menu which is being stick to the top, we need to employ JavaScript there. But in this particular case, we are creating this thing without the usage of JavaScript. We are practically observing that how to create a sticking menu bar with the aid of HTML and CSS only and nothing else. So this is the primary thing that I need to tell you. Now all we are going to do, we are going to save this project, get back to our tutorial and reload. And now we can see that the sticky property which has been associated to this blue box, it is now been eliminated and it is now provided to this particular menu holder, but right now it is not working. It is practically getting below all the contents that we have created so far. So how to overcome it? That is why we will be getting back to our project, and here we will be using this particular term which is known as z-index. Now z-index in particular is used in case where we want to elevate a particular element above the rest of the others. For say, it practically determines the stacking order of an element. So if a particular element which has higher z-index, it will be stacked over the rest of the elements, those which have the lower stack values. So if we provide here this particular value for say 99999, this is an arbitrary chosen value, so we can provide any kind of value over here. But the first thing that we need to remember, that in each and every cases, whenever we apply z index, the element that we want to elevate up should have higher z index than the lower ones. So we have provided this value over here. Now all we are going to do, we are getting back to our project and reload. And now we can see that our menu, it is practically sticking on top of this particular mother wrapper, and the rest of the elements, all those rest of the elements, those are present inside your HTML browser, those are practically being scrolled down below this particular menu holder. If we provide instead of margin zero auto condition, if we provide a top margin of 100 pixels, get back to our project, reload. So all we can see here that the top margin of this particular menu holder is now descending down to 100 pixels. And now if we scroll up our page, we can see that actually this menu holder is now sticking to the top position. And on the other hand, the rest of the contents, those are being scrolled down below this particular menu holder. We have applied a definitive position sticky over here. The Z index can only be applied to some particular elements, those which have positional values. That means the position relative or absolute or fixed is been specified. Only in these particular cases we can apply this particular z index value. We have provided a position sticky over here. So what is the function of this sticky position? We have discussed it earlier in our previous tutorial just prior to this particular video. The sticky position practically toggles between the relative and the fixed position up to the particular threshold value. Just prior to reaching that particular threshold value, the position sticky will be executing a position relative, and whenever that particular threshold value is reached, then the position will be executing a fixed position in the defined area where we actually defined that particular element to be fixed on. So this is the purpose of position sticky, and we have defined that it should be sticking to the top position, and this is what exactly is going on over here. This particular menu holder, it has a 100 pixels margin from the top, and when we scroll up, whenever position top 0 pixels is met up to this particular point, the position of this menu holder is actually acting as a position relative now. But whenever position top 0 pixels is met, we can see that the position is now toggled into the fixed position. So this is how position sticky actually works, and this is how we can create a sticky menu bar on the top of our page without JavaScript. But on the other hand, I would like to mention again that in case if we want a better harmony, and if in case we want a better tune up for our project for some particular specification, in that particular case we must employ JavaScript here. So that's all for today's tutorial. In the next tutorial, as we have told you before, that we will be discussing on this background image and know all the properties associated. So stay tuned, and if you have liked this video tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button down below. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.